So there's, you know, you've got your four stages, and the first one is infancy. And this is where the site is between 0 to 10 recurring members, or between 0 and 10 one-time purchases per month. So even if you sell, if it's not recurring, that's fine, but 0 to 10. And the main challenge at this stage is you don't know what you're doing. Like, the hurdles are you got to actually build the site, there's technical challenges, and you've got to find a sales message that works to get a few customers. And this is where I really encourage people to keep it simple. Go out there with the simplest thing you can think about. Don't try to start a community, obviously, because there's going to be no one to engage there, right? The second stage is childhood, and this is from 10 to 100 members. And the biggest challenge here is sales. Basically, more lead sources, more partners, different ways to sell the same thing. Meaning, if you can get above 10 sales a month or 10 recurring members a month, you should be able to, with that product, get up to 100 members a month just by more sales and marketing. And one of the, I don't know if it's cliche or not, but one of the things that I heard along the way, this guy was talking about his dad, who was a magician and was very successful. And he said, his dad told him all the other magicians, they would always change their act and come up with new amazing things to try to go back to the same audience. And he said his dad was successful because he changed his audience, not his act. So he got his act down, and he changed his audience, and he went all over the place because it was new to them, right? And this is where I'm saying, you got a basic product in infancy, 0 to 10. In childhood, you try to get above 100, which is really just changing your audience. It's different lead sources and markets and so forth. And the next stage, adolescence, this is from 100 to 500. And your main challenge here is actually retention, because once you get above 100 and you're kind of pushing up into the multiple hundreds, you've got to figure out retention. Initially, it was just sell, 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 you know, figure that out. And now it's retention. How do I keep them longer? Because you start finding them falling out the back end as quick as they're coming in. And then the last stage, number four, adulthood or maturity, is where you're now creating new products. And for example, people will, so if you think of these 0 to 10, 10 to 100, 100 to 500, and 500 plus, some people will try to start a mastermind group right here. Their site's not even done. And we also offer a high-end mastermind. It's $1,000 a month or 25K a year or whatever. And it's like, I know you see the gurus doing that, but you don't have anyone to sell into it. You don't have a low-end feeder, right? And even here at 0 to 100, you might be able to offer maybe a premium level of your course or something, but really focusing on, you know, getting over that 100 and momentum behind sales would serve you more than creating more product offerings. Right here, where you're 100 to 500, you can start to create product offerings if your retention's good, but typically people suffer from retention. And then when you go 500 plus, then it's easy to make a lot of money. I mean, if you solve these problems first, like, I know how to build the site, I know how to sell it, I know how to retain, now I can make other products because I'll have 500 plus people to sell into my mastermind. You know, you don't need a high percent conversion to have a decent mastermind. But if you start it in these other areas, it's going to hurt, right? With this one, with getting into retention, that's where you can introduce a community because there's going to be enough people to interact. You know, it's not going to be a ghost town, basically, which is what a lot of people end up with when they launch their site. They're all excited. They launch it. They get a few members. Those members come in, realize they're the only members, and they quit. So it's kind of like, you know, if you take it in order, typically you're able to save yourself a lot of wasted effort, but it actually optimizes the experience for the users as well, because there's kind of these critical mass points that help them have better engagement. So hopefully that makes sense, but people so often get stuck doing the wrong thing at the wrong time. It's not the wrong thing overall, just sometimes the wrong time for their stage. So I just wanted to share that if it's helpful.